If I may, Your
Yes,
Honor.
Mr. Chair.
Just an interjection dun sa tanong sa ano. Yung sinabi niyong follow-up operation sa Pasig, ang primary target niyo doon si...
Your Honor, yung trabaho na yon, ang may hawak ng intel packet is Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez.
Is Colonel Ibanez around? Can you please join us, Colonel? Your Honors and Colonel, base dun sa report that the committee received, no, from the reports, the spot reports, the affidavits that was submitted to the committee, yung operation in Pasig was a mere serving of a warrant of arrest. Hindi naman trabaho ng PDIG yun, di ba? May warrant section yung PNP. So, naglalaro na naman sa isipan natin dito yung sinasabing alleged cover-up, di ba? At saka yung sinasabing in layman's lingo, Your Honors, yung palit ulo. Kasi, bigla all of a sudden, meron kang 990 kilos of shabu na nahuli, tapos nag-follow up kayo, yung follow-up operation nyo is just serving a warrant of arrest to a certain Mr. Juden Francisco.
Your Honor, that was not the target, Your Honor. Ang revelation ni Mayo is bodega, Your Honor. Mas marami pang makukuha doon sa Pasig, and it was confirmed by Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez, Your Honor, na mas marami pa nga doon na makukuha sa Pasig area, Your Honor. So, because of the higher objectives and good faith, nag-proceed ang team ni Colonel Ibanez doon sa Pasig, Your Honors.
Mr. Chair, ano ang nakita doon sa kwan, sa Pasig, sa bodega na sinasabi ni Colonel Ibanez?
Your Honor, because of the cancellation of the operations, Your Honor, hindi na po natuloy yung operation na yun, Your Honor. And then, yung napitas nila ay may warrant, Your Honor. But based on the revelations of Mayo and confirmed by Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez, it was a warehouse, Your Honor. So sa kagustuhan naming makakuha ng mas malaking objective, Your Honor, nag-strategize po kami para pumunta doon ng Pasig, Your Honor.
And that was the report to you by Colonel Ibanez.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yun ang kwan.
Kaharap po sa aming director, si Colonel Ibanez, na sinasabi niya nga po yun, Your Honor, yung mas malaking target.
Doon. Now I understand. Thank you, Your Honor. Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Acop. Congressman Busita.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Gusto ko lang i-clarify, Mr. Chair, dito sa Special Investigation Task Group, SITG 990. General Domingo, former director of PDEG, may information akong nabasa na ipinareview mo yung CCTV footage. Is it true?
Yes, Your Honor. Actually, kami talagang nakakuha ng CCTV footages na yan. At nung nakita po natin na may mga kababalaghang nangyari, may pagpupuslit, may pilferage, ay nireport po agad natin sa CPNP, former CPNP, which nag-create siya ng SITG. Sinabit ko na rin po sa SITG yung footages na yan. So, as well as with Napolcom.
So, Mr. Chair, totoo na nireport mo ito kay former CPNP, General Azorin, and the former DCO, General Santos.
Yes, sir. We recovered that footages 5 days after the 990 operation.
So doon nag-start yung SITG 990?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
If I may, Congressman Busita lang, para lang ma-interjection lang to do sa sinabi ni General Domingo. Para lang for purposes of our information, General Domingo. So, nag-submit ka ng ng CCTV footages, no? So, do you confirm the veracity of those tapes or those CCTV footages para lang alam din namin.
Mr. Sir, Your Honors, that CCTV footages were taken for intelligence purposes only, not an evidentiary, sir.
Who took, what do you mean for intelligence purposes?
So, in our desire, sir, to identify the cohorts of Sergeant Mayo.
Oh, so, si Sergeant Mayo ang nakita mo doon?
Yes, sir. We to identify the cohorts of Sergeant Mayo, we initiated that move, that CCTV backtracking, mm-hmm, purposely to identify the cohorts of Sergeant Mayo. But then, iba po nakita natin, yung team mismo na nakahuli ng 90 kilos ay siyang nakita natin sa CCTV na nagpuslit ng illegal drugs bago pa man kami dumating ni Colonel Ulunan bandang mga alas 4 na ng hapon, sir.
Oh, mahaba-haba yung footage na yun. If I'm not mistaken, 8 oras hanggang 10 oras. Doon sa footages na yun, General, nakita mo ba si Sergeant Mayo doon?
Yes, sir. Yung pabalik-balik. Papasok.
Okay. So, salamat po. Congressman Busita, you may continue.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Thank you. Follow-up question, Mr. Chair, kay General Domingo. May nabasa rin po ako, Mr. Chair, na report na binabanggit dito na ni-recommend ni General Domingo through the former Directorate for Intelligence na gamitin si Mayo para makuha yung mas malaki, and accordingly this was approved by former Chief PNP, and yes, nabanggit dito former Chief PNP and DCO then General Santos yung iyong recommendation na gamitin si Mayo para doon sa follow-up operation na may intention ka na para mas malaki yung makuha. So, yun ang nandito na sa nabasa kong report eh. Is it true?
Yes, Your Honor. It is correct.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Thank you, Congressman Busita. Balikan ko lang let General yung sinabi mo kanina na nakita mo doon sa video na balik-balik si... Sino yung pabalik-balik?
Sergeant Miles.
Ayun, nakita mo. No?
Yes, sir.
Would you more or less give us the idea, anong oras yun nakita mo?
That was between 11:50 in the morning up to 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon, sir.
So 11 to 2 to 3.
Yes,
yeah, ganun. So yes. Hindi 4 hindi 4 o'clock as narrated by Lieutenant Sosonko.
Mr. Chair, if I may, so that this committee will be able to see the whole picture. If I may present my preliminary, sir.
Oh, so you have a presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Matagal ba yan, General?
15 minutes, sir.
Oh, sige. Okay. Yes.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I would like to thank the Secretary of the Interior and Local Government, Attorney Abalos, for his press briefing last week. It facilitates the vindication of those who are innocent of the imputed irregularities and will once and for all hold accountable those persons who are actually connected with the seized discovered 1.032 tons of shabu. Oh, May I also thank the chairman of this committee for this opportunity. To reveal what really transpired on October 8 to 14, 2022. For the record, I am Police Brigadier General Narciso Di Domingo, former Director PDIG. Sir, I was designated as Director of PDIG on October 8, 2022, exactly 2 months prior to the biggest drug haul in the history of the Philippine National Police. Mr. Sir, Your Honors, sorry, na-post forward po. Mr. Chair, Your Honors, the 990 kilos of shabu that we seized in Tondo in October 8 and 9, 2022 were properly inventoried in the presence of mandatory witnesses and in accordance with law. In fact, those 6,990 kilos of shabu were already destroyed by PDIA on March 16, 2023, by order of the court. Meanwhile, the two arrested suspects were already charged in court and remained under detention pending trial of their criminal cases. Moreover, Police Master Sergeant Mayo was already dismissed from the police service. For the record, may I emphasize that there was no massive attempted cover-up that happened. Otherwise, I would not have taken actions and reported the following to higher headquarters. One, we arrested one PDIG personnel with 190 kilos of shabu and filed charges against him and his cohort. Two, we would not have conducted CCTV backtracking in the crime scene to possibly identify other cohorts of the suspects. Three, we would no longer have exerted efforts to identify those who are actually involved in the pilferage. Four, you would not have exerted efforts, sir, Your Honor, to recover the pilfered 42 kilos of shabu and had submitted the CCTV footages to the SITG 990 and to the National Police Commission. Five, to ensure the integrity of the cases filed against the suspects, I have been personally reported to the Honorable Secretary of Justice, Attorney Boyeng Remolia, and with the concerned personnel of the National Prosecution Service for their wisdom and guidance relative to the 990 kilo case. Six, I had always informed former Chief PNP all significant actions taken and developments for his information and guidance. And lastly, the supposed pilferage happened hours before me and my ground commander, Colonel Olonan, actually arrived at the crime scene at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon of October 8, 2022. The CCTV footage showing me and other officers having discussion around was at around 7 o'clock na, sir, sa ng gabi. And it was not our way to plan or discuss a cover-up. What you had, Mr. Chair, Your Honors, was the strategic operation plan, supposedly to locate another warehouse where we could possibly seize another bigger stacks of illegal drugs. With the use of the revelations taken from Master Sergeant Mayo and the suggestion of Police Lieutenant Colonel Arnulfo Ibanez, which were divulged during that time. There is indeed pilferage that transpired, but we discovered that there were individuals bringing out luggages and putting them into vehicles only 5 days or 5 days after the 990 operation. At nakita po natin yan doon sa CCTV na nakuha natin during backtracking for intel purposes. Upon discovery of the pilferage, I immediately initiated appropriate actions to recover pilfered suitcases of shabu. As a result, we successfully recovered the 42 kilos of shabu from the culprits, making the drug haul now a total of 1.032 tons of shabu na naiwas po nating masinghot ng ating mga kababayan na mga adik at magiging adik pa lang. Napakasakit po, Your Honors, na kami na itong nakahuli ng nakabawi ng 1.032 tons na illegal drugs. Kami pa ngayon ang tinuturo ng SITG 1990 nasangkot at kakasuhan sa kasong kriminal at administratibo. The investigation should have focused more on the arrested, as earlier mentioned by Honorable Akok. The investigation should have focused more on the arrested policeman and his cohorts instead on us who operated and consequently arrested Mr. Mayo. Baka po pwede rin masilip, Mr. Your Honors, matanong o malaman natin mula sa SITG 990 kung bakit sa nagdaang 6 na buwan sa halip na tingnan kung sino-sino mga kasamuat ni Sergeant Mayo ay sa amin, sa akin nakasilip at pilit hinahanapan ng mali. Worst, the SITG 990 had accused the restrictive custody of our vital witnesses, the investigators on case, arresting officers, and even the evidence custodian in our filed 990 kilos case for restrictive custody. Had I not appealed to the chairman is ITG 990 that it will cause the dismissal of the 990 case, the restriction may not have been cancelled. Just last week, the PNP is ITG 990 announced to the world that 49 PDIG personnel, including me, were found liable for criminal and administrative prosecution regarding the alleged cover-up. Naiyak po yung mata ko, Your Honors, dahil may order pa na disarmahan kami lahat.
Please wrap up, General Domingo.
Yes, sir. The strategy to fight and curb illegal drugs operations is very much different from other common crimes, Your Honors, where a case is considered solved as soon as the suspect is arrested and charged in court. It is much more complicated. We seriously take and consider all available information as situation dictates. In this particular operation, I took appropriate charges for all actions based on my own judgment calls. I fear that, Your Honors, that the drug syndicate, which had lost over 7 billion pesos worth of shabu, may have struck back as they have the money, power, and resources to counteract and knock down even a police brigadier general. Paano lang yung mga ordinaryong policeman? As we all see, kami pa ngayon, pati pamilya namin, ang nagmukhang masama. Ito, sir, very important po to. May continue, sir.
Sige, please. Kindly wrap up.
Yes, sir. The self-confessed whistleblower, Police Lieutenant Colonel Glenn Gonzalez, was actually the one who has the personal knowledge on the exact location of this 1.32 tons of shabu being taken care of by Mayo. Kaya nga po, nandun siya sa crime scene mismo. Hindi naman siya assigned sa PDIG, hindi siya anti-drugs operative, pero nandun sa araw na yun, sa oras, mga oras na yun. At the time, assigned po siya sa Quezon City Police District. And I believe, Your Honors, he is also the same informant doon sa seized 575 kilos of shabu just last month, worth around 4 billion pesos. Well, in Baguio, sir.
In
Baguio. Just last month. It is just a kilometer away from his residence. Nang sinita ko po siya, sir, bakit nandun? Bakit siya nandun? Ang sagot niya, sir, informant ko ginamit dito. Yung monetary rewards, sir, dapat ibigay natin. For the record, Mr. Chair, Your Honors, I had personally given millions of pesos already to our informants in our previous accomplishments. He utilized his men, who at that time were assigned with the Intelligence and Foreign Liaison Division of PDIG, his former unit before his reassignment to QCPD, led by Police Master Sergeant Tribosora, who, by the way, together with Sergeant Catarata, was already cited for contempt by the Philippine Senate on March 15, 2023. That particular team, the same team which had earlier seized the 990 kilos of shabu, was the team that took out some suitcases outside the crime scene.
Papaot ko lang po.
Police Lieutenant Colonel Adolfo Ibanez, the immediate commander of the arrested Mayo, was the one who assured me that we would get a bigger warehouse of illegal drugs through the use of Mr. Mayo. At that particular time, Mr. Seri Honors, it dawned to me that nilaglag ni Gonzales si Mayo na bata ni Ibanezer, gustong gumanti ni Ibanez, ituro din yung budiga ni Gonzales bilang ganti. Kaya pumayag po ako at na-recommend ko sa former CPNP na magkaroon ng follow-up operations. Nagbigay ng clearance ang former CPNP, kaya sinabihan ko si Colonel Ibanez, ituloy na niya yung follow-up operation. Unfortunately, after 1 hour, pinakancel po ng former CPNP ang follow-up operations. Baka daw patay ni Ibanez si Mr. Mayo. Inutusan din po ako ni Chief na siguraduhin makasuhan si Mayo. Kaya po hanggang ngayon, nasa kulungan po si Mr. Mayo, sir, your honors, at ang kaniyang kasabwat. Klaruhin ko lang po, pinahal ang usapan namin ng former chief. May isa sa gawa kaming follow-up operation sa isang bodega na may mas maraming droga. Wala po kaming pinag-usapang itago si Mayo at huwag i-report ang 990 kilos ng shabu. As a matter of fact, habang pinaplano namin paano gagawin ang follow-up, nag-umpisa na po ang inventory ng 990 kilos with the presence of the mandatory witnesses, DOJ, media, and barangay
officials.
The report citing Mayo as arresting officer of Jurin Francisco and 7 others, and for the recommending award for Police Master Sergeant Mayo, was just a mere memorandum, your honors, addressed to the Director Pidig, addressed to me, signed by Police Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez of SOU NCR, apparently to save the head of his man, Master Sergeant Mayo. He even sent a team to Police Station 3. Doon po namin na turnover si Mayo, ang unang nakulong, sir. Nagpadala po doon siya ng team para papirmahin si Mayo na ng affidavit na siya yung naka-arrest kay Jurin Francisco. But then he failed because I specifically instructed the station commander of Police Station 3, Manila Police District, never to allow anyone to come near Master Sergeant Mayo. I also disapproved, sir, the memorandum of Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez and had never endorsed it to the national headquarters. I know he was just trying to cover up Mayo. As to why Master Sergeant Ribosora and Catarata were not arrested when they left the 42 kilos of shabu outside Camp Crami, please be informed, your honors, that these culprits are very seasoned operatives, so that they are already with PDEG for several years now. So naturally, they know how we think as their director, ano po yung possible naming gagawing courses of action. They practically know the ins and outs of illegal drug trade. And at that time, kung hindi ko i-secure yung 42 kilos na yun, baka hindi ko na na-recover. So my main focus at that time was to recover the 42 kilos. Dahil nga alam ko, na alam nila na huhulihin ko sila. Kaya nagkaroon po tayo ng negotiation, your honor, with Colonel Portera, the Chief Intelligence officer of PEDIC at the time. If ever we see sense of omission here, it might be that when I was designated as director of PEDIC 2 months earlier, I did not bring with me my own men except my drivers and security. I put all my trust to PEDIC personnel as is where is. Let me further inform this committee that upon assumption as director PEDIC on August 8, 2022, I disseminated to all PEDIC Special Operations Unit nationwide never to adopt the system of 70-30 since the chief PNP is very supportive in our fight against illegal drugs and had personally assured me that he will give monetary rewards for our informants in our successful operations. Again, I'm afraid, Your Honors, that the drug syndicate who actually owns this 1.032 tons and who are still in with the PNP succeeded in redirecting the course of investigation, which as they see it was already going to them, they made some strategies that the course of investigation will make a complete U-turn. Now it is now directed to General Domingo. Ang dapat po natin tingnan dito, Your Honors, ay kung sino ang mga boss ni Police Lieutenant Colonel Gonzales at Police Lieutenant Colonel Ibanez. Kung gusto po nating malaman kung sino-sino pa ang mga nasa taas nila sa PNP na talagang involved sa illegal drug trade. Sa kanila po dapat mag-focus instead na sa supposed procedural lapses, tactical decisions, judgment calls ng commander sa baba at sa judgment calls ko, good faith ko sa operasyong ito. For the record, Mr. Chair, I'm very sad that earlier the timeline as discussed on this particular operation was discussed openly. I am afraid our the biggest drug haul so far of the government now pending in court will be dismissed. And one morning we will wake up looking at Sergeant Mayo going out of jail because of these proceedings. So the following...
Mr. Chair, may I object to the statement of the General? Yes. Now because of these proceedings, Sergeant Mayo will go free? No, it is because of what you did. Not us. I take exception to that statement, Mr. Chair, and let it be off record. Hindi po kami sa proceeding na ito, makakalibre si Mayo. Doon pa lang sa una, nung tinamper ninyo yung ebidensya na nandun, that is, you have violated the chain of custody of evidence.
Yeah, the observation of Congressman Acop is noted. And let me reiterate that it is not this committee, if and ever, cases will be dismissed against personalities involved in this 990 kilo of shabu, it is not this committee who was instrumental in the dismissal of such cases.
I am sorry, Your Honors, but my point is Sergeant Mayo may use this proceeding in his defense in court, and the court may subpoena these proceedings to prove that the timeline of events submitted to the court is different from the...
Yeah, okay. Sergeant Mayo is also present via Zoom and we will ask. He will also have the opportunity of being asked later.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Congressman.
Gusto ko lang sabihin kay General Domingo na yung mga reports nyo naman sa mga timelines, kahit nanggaling sa inyo eh. Hindi naman nanggaling sa amin. So why put the blame on us? Ang problema sa inyo, you cannot take life. Oh, ang kwan ninyo is blame ninyo na yung SITG. Blame nyo na kayo ngayon ang kwan. You must remember that when you are a commander, yung phrase na command responsibility is automatically attached to you. All the things that your men will do or will not do, you are responsible. That is the essence of command responsibility. Iho, kaya huwag sumama ang loob mo. Kasama sa serbisyo ito. Ikaw nga, wala pang kaso sa korte. Ako, umabot na ako hanggang sa Korte Suprema. Pulis ako na nakasuhan. Congressman na ako na na-dismiss sa Korte Suprema. So magtiis ka. Hindi yung sasabihin mo na hindi ginagawa ng pulis, kasamahan ng pulis yung ginagawa nila. Kasamahan mong naka-uniforme yan eh. Yun ang mam mo. You have patience. Baka namang dun pa lang sa regional trial court, dismiss na yung kaso mo eh. Hindi ka aabot sa Korte Suprema. For 19 years, I suffered what you are going to suffer as you are thinking. Hindi pa naman nangyayari. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Thank you, Congressman Acop. And that ends your presentation, General Domingo, di ba?
I do have some revelations, Your Honors, if you allow us to...
No, we will do that later. We will give you time to do that so that we can proceed with the questioning by members.